We've been looking at using JWTs alongside refresh tokens so that when the JWT expires, we can get a new one without the user having to enter their full credentials, just having to send the refresh token along with the JWT. And we've done all the work on the server for that. And so if we look at our server in Swagger, we now had these four endpoints in terms of authentication. We've got the register, we've got the login, and the login, as well as giving you back the JWT, also now gives you back the refresh token. And then we can use the refresh token if the JWT is expired. We pass them both in and that will give us back a new JWT, or we can revoke the refresh token so that even if somebody with a refresh token tries to do a refresh, it's not going to be accepted because we've revoked it. And so that's what we had. And now we want to add that functionality to our Blazor application so that when that's running up, we can do these refreshes and make it seamless from the user's point of view that we're actually sometimes doing a refresh. So the first thing we've got to do is we've got to go to our login response. And remember that now has to have the additional property that is the refresh token, because that's what we're giving back. So we'll add that in there. Just copy that one, in fact, pop it down here, and we'll just call this the refresh token. Okay, so that's the data we were already getting back there. Then the next thing we need to do is we need to make sure that when we log in, that refresh token gets stored alongside the JWT. So if we go to our authentication service, and then in here, when we do the login, we've also got to store the refresh token. So in fact, what I need to do is create another key. So let's copy that one, call this refresh key, and pop that in there. And then down here, there we're saving the JWT. So we also want to save the refresh token. And so that's stored in the same place as we're storing the JWT. There are various places you might want to store the refresh token, and you can look online to see the pros and cons of each one, but we're just going to put it in the session storage, same place as the JWT. Now, having done that, we now need to have this idea of actually calling the refresh. So remember, we've got this refresh endpoint that allows us to use the refresh token to get back a new JWT. And that uses a model that actually we can just steal from the server. So here we've got the server, and if we go in there and go into authentication on here, there you can see we've got the refresh model, and that's what we send when we do a refresh. As I mentioned in an earlier video, because we've got C# both ends of it in Blazor, we could actually have a shared DLL for this, but I'm just going to be lazy and do a copy and paste. So here I'm going to add into my models, we're going to call this a refresh model, and then in there I'll just paste in the class so it exactly matches what we had at the other end. Then the next thing I need to do is I need to actually make some use of this. So if we go to, again, the authentication service, and in here I'm going to need to have another method that I'm going to call refresh async. So this is going to be a public async. It's going to return a boolean to say whether the refresh has been successful or not. We'll call it refresh async. And then that's going to take no parameters. Then we're going to create this model. So we'll say var model equals new refresh model that we just copied over. And the data we need in there, remember, is the access token. And that we can get from the session storage. So we'll do an await session storage service dot get item async. And then what we're getting is going to be a string. And then we pass in the JWT key in that case. And then the second thing we want is our refresh token, and that is going to be very similar, except it's going to be the refresh key. So that's that model sorted out. Then we're going to need to send that off to the server. So we can say var response equals await, and then we do what we did before. So let's copy a bit of that. We do our factory, create client, pop that in there. The difference is we're not doing a login, we're doing a refresh. And of course the model's different, but we've called it model, so that works fine. So that will call the new endpoint that we created last time. Then we've got to do the normal sorts of checks. So we're going to say if, and then if it's not successful, then we're going to do a couple of things. We're actually going to log out So remember, we'd already written the logout up here, and it's going to remove the key. We should really also be changing that so that we remove the refresh key as well, so that will just keep that tidy. So what we also need to do in here is actually call revoke back on the server. So this, remember, is one of the big differences in the way the security of a JWT works from the way a refresh token works. The refresh token can be revoked. And so given that we log out, we don't simply forget the refresh token in the browser, we also tell the server to forget it so that even if someone's stolen it, they can't make use of it. So what we additionally have to do there is we say var response equals, and then we're going to again steal some of that code. So we'll paste that in, but then remember a few differences. One is that's going to be the revoke. The revoke we'd set up as a delete, and therefore it doesn't have any kind of payload. It was just taking no parameters at all. So we do that, and that will then revoke it on the server side. We should really make this bit conditional, because we only want to do the revoke if the user is explicitly logging out. We don't need to do the revoke if we're doing the logout because our refresh has failed. But let's just keep it simple. But there is a slight overhead there that's not really necessary. We don't really need the response. This thing is either going to succeed, in which case we revoked it, or it's going to fail, in which case we didn't have access anyway. But just so we can do something with the response and see what's going on, what I'm going to do there is just a console write and then just pass into that revoke gave response and then response dot status code. So notice that in Blazor, if you want to do what would in JavaScript be a console.log, you can do the console.write, or in this case do it async, and that will achieve the same thing. So we can just see what's going on. So that's our logout async sorted that we had called down here in the refresh if we had a problem, if we failed to do the refresh. The next thing we've got to do there is we've got to do a return of false, because remember, this is telling whoever called it whether that refresh has worked. On the other hand, if we've got a successful status code, that has worked okay. And so we now need to get hold of the new JWT. So we do a var content equals, and then we can say await response.content.readFromJSONAsync. That's a generic, and we're going to be reading the login response that we'd already written. Remember, both the login and the refresh give us back a login response, so we've done that. Then we need to do some other checks, and in fact, most of these we can now pinch from the login async. So we need to check whether the content is null, and we need to get hold of those two items. So we'll copy that and paste it in here. We also need to clear out the JWT cache. Remember, we had this cache just to save making those asynchronous calls, but we need to set that to the new JWT. So we'll just say underscore JWT cache equals content dot JWT token. And then that's it. We can just return true and everyone will be happy. So that's the extra feature added to the service. And now we need to call that in response to any kind of authorization failure. We're not going to know exactly why authorization has failed. We're not getting very much information back on that. But we've got to take the guess that if the authorization's failed, it's because our JWT has expired and therefore we need to do a refresh. And we can do that actually as part of the same authentication handler that we used previously in order to inject the JWT into the header and send it off to the server. So that's what we had here. We've got this authentication handler, and all of this code that we had there is dealing with the request going out, but we can also use these to do extra processing on the response. Now, you might say, would it be better to have this in a separate handler, because you can have multiple handlers chained together, but they are both to do with authentication. They're quite tightly bound together, so I think I'm going to put in the same one. It'll just make the code a bit simpler. You might want to put it separately. So what I'm going to do is, rather than just returning that base send async, which is when it actually sends the request, I'm going to say var response equals, and that response is this HTTP response message, which is what we're ultimately returning. So after that, I'm going to say return that. But in the meantime, I'm going to check to see whether the authorization failed, because if it did, then we know that we've got to do this refresh. So what I'm going to do is, firstly, I'm going to add another member on this. I'm going to have a private Boolean which I'm going to call refreshing. And that will default to false. And the reason I'm doing this is to prevent recursion, because when we do the refresh, we're making a call to the server, which will come through here, and that might cause us problems. So what I'm going to do is just check that we're not already refreshing. So if not refreshing, I then want to check that we've actually got a JWT, because if we haven't got a JWT, then clearly we haven't got an expired JWT, so there's no point in attempting a refresh. So we'll say not string dot is null or empty on the JWT. And then the other thing we want to check for is that the response did fail on the basis of not being authorized, not for some other reason, in which case, again, what would be the point in trying to do a refresh if that wasn't the problem? So we'll just have HTTP status code dot unauthorized, and I'll just tidy that up by putting that into a using statement. Okay, so if all of those things are okay, we know we want to attempt a refresh. So next thing I'm going to do is put in a try block. And in here, the first thing I'm going to do is have that underscore refreshing and set that to true. So that means that we won't come in here twice. And then I'm going to have a finally block where we're going to set that to false. So a safe way of making sure that we don't come through this code twice. And the finally means whatever happens, we will get out of that. Then we need to call the authentication service. So we've already got the authentication service injected in here. So we can say if, and then we'll do an await, and then authentication service dot, and the refresh that we just wrote. It's not showing up there. That's because I forgot to put it into the interface. So let's just do that. Let's take that one there. And then if we go up to the interface, pop it in there, then that will give us what we want. And so back in our handler, we now should have the refresh async. It doesn't take any parameters. So that's just call that. And if that's worked okay, that means we should now have the new JWT. So we're going to have to try again with the new one because we failed on the expired one. So I'm going to say JWT, we've already got the variable for that, equals, and then we can just call that same function, but now it'll give us the new one, which hopefully will be working. And then we're going to do basically the same thing we did here. So we're going to check that we've got a JWT. We're going to check that it's going to the server. And if it is, we'll add that new JWT into the authorization header. And then we're going to repeat ourselves by reissuing this same request, but with the new JWT in the header. So all of that code, we're really repeating ourselves to some extent. We probably could have factored it out, but I think it's clearer if we just lay it out like this. So that's what we're going to do. We're going to resubmit the request, but with the new JWT. And that really should be all we need to do. So if we run that one up and drag it over, and at the moment it's failing, if we just pop up the console, we'll be able to see the console messages coming in. If we pop up the server console, then we can see that that corresponds to what we've got. So we've failed to retrieve the data because the JWT isn't present. If I do a login, normal stuff, then we should see that we got the login call, the login succeeded, and we've now, remember, got 30 seconds, that's all, to get our reviews done. So we can see there we're getting access to it. That's all working fine. And you can see it's telling us each time that we're within the time available. So that's just the normal stuff of using the JWT. But as time goes by, remember we've got the 5 second leeway on that, but eventually we're going to hit the point where we get the failure. So we can see we got the on challenge. That's what told us that the JWT had failed because it's expired. But then because of what we put into that handler on the client, it called refresh, the refresh succeeded. We then resubmitted the request for the data with the new JWT, and that worked. If we keep going again, though, we're eventually going to expire on this new token, and because the refresh token only had a minute, then we're going to have the refresh called, but we can see that that failed. So we can see there, that's where that was our message, revoke gave response unauthorized, and so now we're not allowed in there. We haven't got a new JWT, so we've got to go back and go through the whole thing again. Obviously, doing that with 30 seconds and a minute is not a good idea, but you can see the benefits we can have with both of those. The other thing, remember, we did is on our logout, we made it so that it actually tidied everything up. So if we just check that, we can see that if we go to application and give that a bit more room, there we can see we've got both of the keys in there. If I do a logout, they disappear, and also we can see we call the revoke, so that means it's disappeared from the database, and so we wouldn't be able to use that at all, even if someone had stolen that refresh token and stolen a JWT, because the refresh token is no longer in the database, they couldn't get back in there. So that's the whole of that system of refresh. We saw in the previous video what to do on the server. We saw here what to do in Blazor. As I mentioned, Angular and React, I'll leave you to work that out for yourself unless there's real demand for it, but I think we've covered enough of that. So, hope you enjoyed that. If you did, do click like, do subscribe, and I'll see you next time.